6 months ago or so, Whitney Tilson was talking about K12, the online learning company, right?
Yes.
That's right.
He was criticizing basically their entire business model and the way that they've been growing so rapidly that they're serving students who really they shouldn't be. About 6 months ago, investor and education reform advocate Whitney Tilson started writing scathing emails about online education provider K-12. Tilson is well known to reformers for both A Right Denied, his documentary film, as well as a popular email blast about education policy. On September 28, 2013, Tilson wrote, "Having become convinced that K-12 is run amok and is doing real educational damage to tens of thousands of children every year and giving our entire movement a huge black eye, what was I supposed to do? Remain quiet? Ha." On October 2, 2013, he wrote, "I have yet to find a single person, at least who's not directly or indirectly on K-12's payroll, who says anything good about this company." Tilson even shorted the stock, meaning that he was betting against the success of K-12. The K-12 stock had been on a tear for the first three quarters of 2013. From late November 2012 to September 10, 2013, the stock price went from $16.17 to $37.85, up 134% in about 10 months. It's always difficult to say why a stock price rises or falls. But about a week and a half after Tilson's negative portrayal of K-12 on September 28th, the stock price melted down, dropping 38% in one day from $28.59 on October 8th to $17.60 on October 9th.
Last September, I put together, well over 100 slide presentation laying out the many things I thought the company was doing wrong. And from an investment perspective, I thought the stock was overvalued. And within 3 weeks, the stock fell by 50% as the company missed its enrollment numbers. And the stock's bounced a little bit since then. But, I haven't covered or added a single share to that position.
6 months ago, Tilson said the majority of students K-12 serves do not benefit from online learning. Does he still think so?
When a company goes public and it has the pressure of public shareholders and so forth who want to see that stock going up, I've seen many, many companies fall into this growth trap. And so I think they've outgrown the subset of students who can really benefit from their schools. And so I think they're serving an awful lot of students who are dropping out at very high rates, who are learning very little. Who will be better served going back to regular bricks and mortar schools.
What does K-12 say for itself about student engagement?
They released a video on YouTube earlier this month.
Academic Day 2014 really represented where we've been the last 6 months. Completely focused on improving student outcomes. We assembled our educators, our educational leaders. They presented innovations that are going on at the school level, things that we are replicating, things we are still testing. We talked a lot about the importance of measuring what we're doing and innovating. We are really doing a good job of it, and we showed everyone what we're doing.
School leaders had intuition. They sensed, I think, some of the things that have been confirmed in the data. And they've begun to move forward on initiatives to engage students better, to make sure students and families are making the right choices.
Tilson's not buying it. He says low test scores and high dropout rate or student churn prove that K-12 has a bad business model. Tilson said the most disadvantaged students are least likely to benefit from a K-12 program.
Data that I'm seeing, the really not just bad, but I've never in my 24 years seen worse test score data than I'm seeing coming out of K-12 schools. So it's almost like they're out of the frying pan into the fire. If they're even worse off, as hard as that is to believe. So it's sort of sad that it's being offered as a lifeline. It's like they're throwing a life buoy to drowning students. But the problem is the life buoy, instead of saving them, is made of concrete and it sinks them to the bottom.
Choice Media contacted K-12, who declined to comment on this story.
So checking K-12 stock today, we see it's in the between $21 and $22 range right now. This is the one-year chart, the big correction that we saw in the package right there. But I don't know, Joe, you were in this business when you were observing Whitney Tilson beating up K-12 on a nearly everyday basis back about 6 months ago. And, the stock bounded back a little bit since then, but still far down from the highs. So I guess if Whitney was short the stock, he is he's made a lot of money on that play. What were you thinking during all that?
Oh, boy. So here's the thing. Whitney Tilson is one of my board members. So in any time you've got a board member that is, sort of becoming part of the story, your role as the head of an organization with that person on the board gets a little bit complicated. I mean, there were a number of people in the education industry who were reaching out to me, hoping that they could talk to Whitney Tilson, and I was sort of in a tough spot. So what I basically had to say is, look, my work is completely separate from investment work that that my board members do. I think that the case that Whitney was making, from where I was looking at it, it did seem to combine his interest for better educational options for kids with his investment work. A lot of what he was talking about was the what he considered to be the poor quality of the education that was being delivered in the first place to kids. To the extent that that people are talking about that and looking at that, that seems to me to be productive pressure, particularly if it results in mid-course corrections or improvements to what's being offered to families,
Sure. And while most of his, criticisms were directed at K-12 in particular, to some it was an indictment of online learning generally. And Whitney did have some statements about, the model more generally as being flawed with respect to Pennsylvania virtual charters, many of whom get their curricula from K-12, by the way. But to what extent did it apply to his views on online learning generally, or, not that I should be interviewing you about his ideas, but anyway, but the point is I don't know, in your opinion, did the general online learning world suffer from the critiques against K-12?
It may have, although, I was just out in the Midwest last week and saw a lot of commercials for some online learning on television. It seems like the industry is going to survive with or without Whitney Tilson. One of the things that was running through my mind, to get back to your other question on your original question on this, was the role that for-profits play in investing in innovation. I think it's innovation itself is something that nonprofits are not particularly adept with, and I think any discussion about what's happening in the for-profit sector has to include some recognition that were it not for the risk takers that are willing to put money into that sector, we might not see the kind of advances that we need to see in terms of efficiencies and modernization of the education reform world.
Yeah, thank you for saying that, because we do hear profits used as a simply a disparaging derogatory term, as if profits themselves are the same people who, as I often say, love their iPhones or Androids and love their profit-driven devices and love their Reebok or Nike shoes made for profit and love their automobile that their favorite car is that was made at a profit and love their favorite restaurant around the corner that makes a profit. They love all these things, and yet in this one realm they'll use profits as if it is some sort of evil thing. Like if for profit means you hate children, you're trying to reduce to the lowest common denominator, rob resources from the classroom to line your own pockets.
And at the same time, and I totally agree with that, at the same time, just because something's for profit doesn't mean it's any good either. And that's, and I think if we get to a part where the marketplace is able to vote with its feet based on what they think is the best options that are out there, I think we're going to be in a good place.